In honor of Black History Month, we're shining a spotlight on Black voices in Bend. Aria Brumfield spoke with a Bend counselor about changes she's seen in her clients during this pandemic.
This week, as we spotlight Black voices in Bend, we're highlighting mental health in the Black community. I sat down with Bend family counselor Tobiah Brown, who says anyone experiencing challenges with their mental health should prioritize receiving care.
This is Tobiah Brown. She's a licensed professional counselor intern, and she works with families and children across the Tri-County area.
For people of color, I think that we are constantly engaged in struggle. And I won't say protest, I'll say we're constantly engaged in trying to make progress.
And after a year like 2020, a year seemingly dedicated to dismantling struggles caused by racism and inequality, Brown says seeking out support for your mental health should be a normalized priority. We talked about trauma and how Black communities historically continue to be disadvantaged through systems like enslavement and oppression, racism and segregation, and now police brutality. And in addition, she says Black people fight a stigma surrounding seeking counseling.
A lot of social service or social help has been used to the detriment of Black folks, the detriment of Latinx folks, the detriment of Indigenous folks. And so when you go to interact with these services, there's always the risk that something bad is going to happen.
Research shows the Black community suffers from an increased rate of mental health concerns, including anxiety and depression. And Brown says Black people and other people of color are now joining more social service professions and bringing different perspectives. And this encourages communities of color to seek therapy and brings more variety to the support they are able to receive.
So I think when you look at the Black community, when I come in and say, hey, I'm here to walk with you, that's much more what we do culturally. That's what we do instinctively and naturally.
And not just with Black people. Brown says she recognizes now, months later, there's an openness with many of her patients wanting to talk about experiences not just related to childhood trauma, but also with race.
But now I'm starting to see that. Now it's a safer space. There's a little more distance so people can say, this is what happened. I don't really know what that means.
Brown uses objects to evoke memories in patients. And during our time together, she walked me through a reflective breathing exercise.
And as you're still breathing in and recognizing those thoughts, we're going to do a little investigation about why you have those thoughts. Where are they coming from?
Brown says Black people seeking support from a counselor and therapist is nothing to be ashamed of. And she says once you examine your mental health by looking at your past and present, it will better equip you for your future. In Bend, Ariel Brumfield, News Channel 21.